So a lot of people have asked me recently about multilingual models and fine-tuning for multilingual models for different languages, etc. So what I thought I'd do is make a video that goes through some of the issues that relate to this and Llama 2. And this is not going to be comprehensive, but it will show you some of the things you need to think about and answer some of the questions that people have posed. So what I've got here is just a little notebook of taking our Llama 2 notebook that we had before, and I've just customized it. So we're just going to be using the tokenizer. We're not actually going to be using the model itself here. And I'm just going to point out what languages Llama 2 is good for, which ones are not good fits with this, and then also some of the other models that you could look at and check out as well. So first off, let's look at from the Llama 2 paper. We can actually see, okay, what languages the model was trained on. And by far, it's English, right? It's mostly English. And even the unknown is probably going to be a large amount of that would be code with maybe English comments, something like that in here. We can see after that, we've got German, we've got French, we've got some Chinese in there, we've got Spanish, Russian, a number of different languages in here. Most of the languages that are represented here, not all of them. We've got things like Korean and Japanese, but most of them are going to be using sort of Roman characters for this. So this is where I want to show where you're going to run into problems with Llama 2. So if we go back to our notebook, you can see I'm just basically bringing in transformers, sentence piece. You will need to basically have a token from Hugging Face Hub to download the Llama 2 tokenizer. And you just click here. Get your token. All you need is a read token and then paste it in here. And you can see that I've just left some of the code in there. I've just commented out the loading the model and we're just loading the tokenizer for this here. Now, the tokenizer for all the Llama 2 models is the same. That's a standard thing. And it's actually pretty sure it's exactly the same as the Llama 1 models as well. So it's not a huge difference there. So once we bring in the tokenizer, we can have a look and see some things about it. So the first thing is that if we look at it, it's 32,000 tokens in total. So when you train your tokenizer or your tokenizer actually learns what are the most probable tokens, what's the best distribution of tokens, you have to basically tell it how many tokens you want it to have. So the tokens are actually chosen through a sort of training process, or really it's a little bit different than training, but it's basically where you pass your corpus in and it works out the best tokens to represent that corpus in the minimum number of tokens per word. So you will see that if we come in and have a look at this, we can see that if I put in this is a tokenizer test, we can see that actually it's breaking this up almost into one token per word here. So the only one that's got two in here is tokenizer. Another interesting thing too is if we look at this, remember basically our tokenizer is what we use to get the text into numbers to pass in to become embeddings to go through the model later on. And so we can see here that it will always append a start token here, and then we've got the tokens going on here. Now I've deliberately put this in capitals, the rest not in capitals. If I flip this around and I make this here to be not capital and tokenizers to be capital, then we can see that, okay, we've got the same start token, but we actually then get different tokens for some of this. So we can see that is the 338 that we've got going on there. And we can actually look at this by doing a tokenizer decode. So by doing a tokenizer decode here, you can see that I can basically take the numbers and convert them back to words. So the one is our start token, which is going to be this, and then we've got this is, and we can see that the this with a capital T is going to be different, right? It's going to be 910 there. And these are just the token numbers. So there are 32,000 of these tokens. And what I want you to realize is that different tokenizers or different sort of learnt tokenizers or different calculated tokenizers are actually going to be, some of them are going to be more suited to certain languages than other ones if we go through this. So if we have a look at Llama 2, we can see that with English, if I say this is a tokenizer test, we get what we had before. And the phrase I'm going to go for here is just my name is Sam. And you can see that if I've got my name is Sam here, That's literally just four tokens. So it's the same as the number of words here. Even the fact that I've got some capitals here, it's going to be four tokens in this case. So our tokenizer for Llama 2 can handle both lowercase and uppercase. It's a cased, what we call a cased tokenizer. And we can see that, okay, with English, it's doing a really good job. In fact, with other European languages, you'll find that it does a pretty good job. So let's look at French. I don't speak French, but I've done a number of these languages. I've just put it into Google Translate and then got it to translate. But you can see, mon nom est Sam, right? Again, four actual tokens used for that. Now, what if we go to a different language? Thai is a language that I can speak. And here we've got where it's saying, pom chu Sam, which basically means I name Sam, all right? If we did a technical translation of this. Now, the Thai script is interesting to look at. I will just explain a few things about it. One of the things with Thai is that you can have your consonants. So this is an S here, but you can actually have your vowels either before the consonant, above the consonant, below the consonant, or after the consonant, or a mixture of those. So this is actually like A-S-M, right? So even though this word here is Sam, it's spelled out A-S-M for this. Now that really doesn't make a huge difference. At the end of the day, these are all just Unicode characters, right? So we can, you know, use a tokenizer to do this. So with the Llama tokenizer though, if I pass this through, suddenly from going from four tokens in English and French, now we're up to 14 tokens. And you can see that here, these three Unicodes are actually just making up one character in here. So this character is actually made up by three different tokens. So that's not ideal, right? We can see that if we were to train something to do a fine tuning for Thai, probably the Llama models are not going to be that great. Because if you're requiring 14 tokens in one language to say something that could be done in four tokens, it's going to be much harder and you're going to need more data for the model to be able to, you know, process. Remember, our tokens, these 32,000 tokens that we've got here, are what we're softmaxing over at the end. So as we come out of the model and we have to predict the next token, right? That's what a large language model does. It's actually just doing a softmax over 32,000 classes in this case. So here you can see if we've got to make 14 predictions to get the same thing that we only needed four predictions, this is not going to be ideal for fine tuning for Thai. Same for Greek. So I certainly don't speak Greek, but I've put this in from Google Translate. With Greek, it's even worse. We've got, it seems to know the characters, which is pretty good, but it's basically making one token per character, which is the worst thing a language model can do. If we want to fit a lot of things in, we don't want character level tokens. That's not the goal here. We want subword tokens or full word tokens. And with Greek, we haven't got that. We've got 23 different tokens for saying the same thing here. Spanish, back to four. So again, we can see this is pretty good. Chinese, we can see, okay, Chinese, again, we've got some of the characters being correct, but then we've got Unicode for making up other characters, multiple Unicodes going on here for making up other characters. So again, to say the same kind of thing, we're now using 12 tokens. It shows that Llama 2, if you want to do a fine tuning for a particular language, take this notebook, put in your language and see how does it go. And I think you'll find that for a lot of the Western European languages, it will be okay. It doesn't mean that it's going to be great for fine tuning in that language, because obviously it's seen far more English than another language. But it turns out that it's interesting that these large language models are able to sort of map from one language to another reasonably well if the tokenizer supports it. If not, then you're probably going to be needing to look for a different model to fine tune. So let's look at sort of the Bloom model. So Bloom has a huge tokenizer. We've got 250,000 different tokens. And you could imagine that this is one of the reasons maybe that the Bloom models don't do as well. I think it's only one of a number of reasons, personally. But you could see that if we're having to softmax over 250,000 classes instead of 32,000 classes, that's going to be much more challenging. Now, Bloom actually uses what's called a byte pair encoding tokenizer. So you'll get this sort of weird character at the start at times. But let's look at this. So we can see that this is a tokenizer test. It's doing a similar thing to what we've got. So it's quite good at English, quite good at French, not good at Thai, not so good at Greek, good at Spanish, definitely better at Chinese than the Llama 2 one. What about if we look at like the GML2 model? So this is a bilingual model. This is an English-Chinese model. And I think it's a very good model. It's trained on quite a lot of data. And it was one of the models that pre-Llama coming along really showed that you could get good results by, or the first version of this is the sequel to it, but the first version really showed that you probably want to train on more than a trillion tokens. And so we look at their tokenizer, we can see that, okay, their tokenizer is 64,000, almost 65,000 tokens. English does a good job again, right? French, not so bad job. Thai, yeah, not so great. But you notice that the ones that it gets here, it's certainly probably better than the Llama one. It's got this character this time, which we didn't get before, but we're still getting Unicode for certain things. Greek, not really. It wasn't trained to support that at all. In fact, it wasn't trained anything to support anything except English and Chinese. Chinese shines at, right? This is definitely a good tokenizer for Chinese. And we can see that we've got multiple characters being represented here. If we look at the MT5 models, the T5 models were models that were trained by Google in 2019. They have a bit of a notorious tokenizer because their tokenizer doesn't support curly brackets or multiple new line characters and stuff like that. The multilingual T5, though, is interesting in that for different languages, this is a pretty good tokenizer. Again, though, it's quite big, right? We're looking at the 250,000 token tokenizer. We can see for English, it does a good job. For French, it does a good job. For Thai, it does a good job. Now, look at this is the first one that it's actually gotten the word I and then name correct here, because this is like Pom Chu Sam. And you can see that this is actually getting the key parts of this right. Now, okay, my name, it's splitting up, which is fine. That probably makes sense. But it's taken something that was 14, 15 tokens in some of the other tokenizers and just brought it down to 4 tokens here. You can see, again, with Greek, we can see it does a much better job than the other tokenizers as well. I can see here that we're getting quite a number of characters in tokens, so it's grouping them together into subwords. Yeah, Spanish, no problem. Again, Chinese, no problem. Perhaps not as good as the one that's made for Chinese, right? The bilingual model, but still as a multilingual model, the MT5 and its tokenizer are actually quite good here. Lastly, just to look at here, one of the open source Llama models. So there were a number of Llama models that was retrained because Llama 1 you couldn't use commercially. So Together Compute did one. I think Stability AI did one. A number of them are out there. And they all seem to be using bigger tokenizers than the original Llama. So here you can see that using a 50K tokenizer, we can see that it's doing similar for English and for French. We can see that this is a BPE tokenizer here. It's not doing a great job for Thai, not good for Greek, and also probably not very good for Chinese. So I wouldn't be using this model and this tokenizer for multilingual stuff. So at some point we may see a multilingual Llama trained with a bigger tokenizer for doing something like this. It wouldn't surprise me at some point if Meta themselves actually released that. They've been pretty good about multilingual stuff in the past. So this is something that you may see in the near future. But anyway, what I wanted to show you with this was if you're thinking of doing your own fine-tuning of a model or its particular Llama model, check first, does the tokenizer actually support this? If you put your language in there and you're seeing that, okay, it's chopping it up to character by character, or sometimes a character having multiple Unicodes to make up that character, you're not going to get a great fine-tuning out of Llama 2. This is one of the sort of most basic things for picking models for doing fine-tuning. Now, the cool thing is there are lots of models on Hugging Face that if you go looking for them in different languages, you will find people often train something from scratch using their own tokenizer. There are quite a number of multilingual models that have multilingual tokenizers, but you want to make sure that you check out this first before you go and spend any money or prepare for doing a fine tuning for this. So hopefully this answers some of the questions that people have had around doing multilingual models and multilingual tokenizers, this kind of thing. I'll be doing a number of different videos about preparing data for fine tuning and then doing the fine tunings and stuff themselves over the next couple of weeks. This is one of the questions that I see people ask a lot, so I thought I would just start off with this one. As always, if you've got any questions, please put them in the comments below. If some really good multilingual models for particular languages, it would be great to see people comment that below so that we can help people out that are looking for certain languages and stuff like that. As always, if you like the video, found it useful, would like to see more things like this, please click and subscribe. I will talk to you in the next video. Bye for now.